day in Ali, and welcome back to our channel.
Hey, tonight's mukbang, we're having oysters. These are huge oysters. Huge oysters, right? So that's going to be my part. And we have prawns, not shrimp.
Finally!
Prawns, right? And then we're having mangrove crab. Mangrove crab. Unfortunately, the mangrove crab here is smaller, right?
And the ones in the pond.
Compared to the ones in Palau. But hey, at least we have it, right? And you know, and in addition to it, we have barbecue ribs, which I kind of like twist it up a little bit. You know, I put some green onions and sesame seeds. So that will be our mukbang for tonight.
And I would like to say tonight's mukbang, the reason why we went all out tonight is because today is our second year anniversary. So cheers to us.
Cheers to us.
I have no sugar coat. So while my husband is getting ready to try the oyster, I will try. Let's watch him. So what are you putting on your oyster?
Putting some soy sauce on it. Soy sauce. I'm putting on the BBQ. Right?
You will never go wrong with BBQ.
You can never go wrong with this thing. So I'm just going to take just a little bit of it. Okay. And so...
Wow, that's a lot of donut.
Yep. And,
some lemon.
Some lemon, of course.
I see you put the ice cube on top.
Yeah,
for...
just make it, just chill it.
The mouth is watery now.
Wish me luck.
I wish you luck.
Excuse me, and here you go.
How is it? Really? Guys, I don't
think it takes a little bit of adjustment when you're putting it in your mouth because it's
too big.
Yeah, too big. And you know, with the PKEQ and that being hot, you know, you don't want to like
spread the whole thing on your mouth.
Slurp it or whatever,
yeah.
Right? So you just
okay, guys. I'm gonna try the prawns. See, my husband actually, if you look at the video earlier, he put a what is this? The stick.
Yeah, the reason I did that is you know, to make it because when you boil it, I guess when you
shrimp
boil
something
like that. So just pull it out.
It's so like
pull it out.
I'm not wearing gloves tonight because this is going to get messy, but
yeah, so.
There, guys, there's eggs. The favorite part. Gosh. Where can I get a soy sauce, please? This time, I didn't make the PKEQ seafood boil sauce. Tonight, I want to experience the local way, which is soy sauce and lemon. Oh babe, you haven't explained this kind of lemon. This is lemoncina.
Lemoncina, yeah. I don't know what they call it in English, so I'm just gonna go off with what we call it in Chamorro.
Yeah.
It's called lemoncina. Very
like a common. Do you find that a lot or no?
Well, you don't.
There'll be season for it?
Yeah, there's a season for it. Of course, you're right. There's a season for it. And, you know, it's good. on almost everything.
Mm.
Yeah, so.
Oh, yes. Look at this.
It's not
prawns. It's not shrimp, guys. Not lobster.
Lobster.
It's prawns.
It's
Can you give me a little bit of the meat, please? Yeah. Just put a little bit on my plate. My mouth is watery now. Today we didn't get lobster only because we have a lot of prawns. And, that's a lot. And mangrove crab. I'm excited for mangrove crab because the last time we had mangrove crab is when we went to Palau. So, it's been a year. Almost a year. So, I'm going to put in some lemon. I'm telling you, it's, I don't know. I know it's going to be that good.
This is dangerous.
Oyster?
Danger.
It's so good. Oh, there we go. The lemon sina?
Yeah, it ran away, but it's okay.
Guys, the prawns. Let's see what's in there. I know I saw eggs. Yep. There you go. When my husband was cooking them, you can literally see the, there. You see the eggs? Mm-hmm. Mm. The prawns are so good. Why don't you, Can we open this thing?
Yeah.
On the female. No, the female. First. Because you know what they say. Female.
So you gotta move over there.
No, show it to the camera though. Show what you. Closer. There, guys, that's the female mangrove crab.
How do you know it's female?
Because you can literally see, there's a difference, this part of the crab, there's a difference here. And not only that, but also the color. When you, and you can see if it's seasonal, I mean, if it's the season for mangrove crab, you can literally see the eggs hanging.
But
you don't see bowls.
So what do you do when you open the...
So this is how I open my mangrove crab.
Well, once you open it, you gotta remove the scales.
To make it easier, when you open the mangrove crab, this is what you remove first. This. So when you remove this, but because you already removed the. There, guys. There you go. I see that. Mm-hmm. I need lemon. This is pica.
Mm-hmm.
That lemon juice. So yeah, what do you call this? I'm gonna try the claw first. Look at this. I wanna show this to you guys. There you go. Honey, you want? I'll share it with you. Here you go. Happy anniversary.
Anniversary.
cheers to us and cheers to our health. I'm sorry, but the cholesterol here is a little bit too much. I just spoke to my father. I mean, family back home. Even my husband, he spoke to his family. They told us slow down or bum soro because seafood are okay. You just don't eat it like every day. But hey, finally my husband found the mangrove crab. So, and it's our anniversary. So,
all out.
Mm-hmm. That's the best word.
That's the word, right?
Mm-hmm. So let's try, guys. With the lemon. This is our first meal for today. So that's why we're going all out. Let's try this. Mm-hmm. You know, when I was growing up, I hear my parents saying that in order for you to keep the meat intact and like making sure that your mangrove crab or your lobster doesn't shrink, boil it first and freeze them. So, how much were the mangrove crab?
Oh my god, it's per pound, right? It was 18.99
per pound for the mangrove crab, and then the prawns were how much for the pound?
I wasn't paying attention actually, but
okay,
it was pricey. That I'll say.
All total of the
but everything was it totaled up to
109
something, yeah.
But again, guys. We saved it for today. Today is just our special day.
Yeah.
We're not going to eat this like every day. How come it's so hard for me to remove the stick? So I hope you guys are doing okay out there. We're not going to talk about the coronavirus because, we're just going to talk about food. So... my advice, guys, if you're planning a seafood boil with your family, try and buy it yourself. I mean, go to the store and get prawns, go and get lobster or crab, oyster, whatever, because it's worth it to buy it at the store rather than ordering it from the restaurant. I think you all watched the video that we had the other day from Red Lobster, and it was very pricey, but
you know,
it's really not worth it.
Yeah, for me, right?
What is that Chamorro word that you always say? The ripoff?
Ripoff?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's ripoff.
It is a ripoff.
No, but there was a Chamorro word that you said before, or like the Chamorro, how they say it.
I forgot. Got.
There, guys, the prawns. The prawns, not lobster. You know, my brother called me and he was making fun of me.
Why me?
He was making fun of me and he goes, can you tell me the difference between a lobster and shrimp? Because from the last video, my husband didn't even like realize that I met some.
You made a boo-boo.
Mm-hmm.
Made a mistake of that.
But you guys know what I mean.
The what is that?
I head on to a lobster and I'd be like, I'm gonna try the shrimp.
Shrimp.
Well, anyways,
the shrimp turned out to be a lobster.
Somehow. But yes, guys, this is good. Thank you, honey.
Yeah.
He's the chef here. So, props to you.
What?
You never fail me. That's the reason why I gain so much weight is because you never fail me. Mm-hmm.
hit the spot.
You it hit does? The spot.
Woo.
So yeah, the pico is kicking his butt.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Again, with the pico EQ, for our loyal customers, we haven't forgot about you. It's
mm-hmm.
just because of this pandemic, we're still in a lockdown. We can't go nowhere but staying indoor.
Mm-hmm.
But we will get that. So. We already tried the mangrove crab, the oyster prawns. Now let's try his barbecue ribs. Here you go. Oh, you want? You don't want to try it?
You know, the chef may, so to speak, may.
There you go. You can see the sesame seeds and the green onion and his barbecue sauce on top.
Mm-hmm.
And he did marinate the ribs, so.
Eat the.
With rice.
That's what you need.
That's what I need.
That's
what we need.
Yeah. The good combination, the perfect combination to with it is. Rice. Either red rice or white rice.
No, steamed rice is the best.
Yeah.
Only because you can. Whatever. I mean, if you eat it with red rice, you won't be able to taste the real flavor of this thing. Mmm. You want?
I'll get it from that one.
Here. I'm making too much mess here. No?
Not yet.
The prawns are really good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He cooked it perfectly, where it's not soft, not raw. Perfect. How long did you cook this for? 5 minutes?
No, it's about 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Just boil it. I mean, I steam it for about 2 minutes.
Yeah. And for all our families and friends who are very special to our corazón, thank you for calling and texting and to congratulate us for our second year anniversary. Thank you guys, we love you. And we hope that, we'll enjoy more years together. We're probably gonna be making a lot of mukbang for you guys. We just need to exercise more because this thing is, oh my God. It's so good with a lot of lemon. Did you take all the lemon seed now?
Yeah.
Mm. It's really good. It's pica.
This might be tasty, good, whatever you call it, right? But if you're not, if you're allergic to it,
don't try it at home.
No.
Make sure you have Benadryl on the side.
You know, if you have issues with this,
Serious, but this thing is pica. That's why it's called pica EQ. Oh, the reason why it's pica EQ is because they're spicy, right? Spicy good. And EQ is our last names together. Also, there was something that I wanted to talk about since it's our second year anniversary. So I want to talk. There's a lot of people have messaged me, messaging me about our video that we shoot in Saipan. So that was our first video together.
Very first
video together, and it was produced by Walter Manglonia.
Yeah.
And we're thinking about shooting another video. I just need ideas, guys. The first song, that song that I wrote was for my husband, of course. I just need to be inspired again. I just hope this pandemic
Inspired?
When I said is inspired, I mean, we're happily together. Like, even if I write another song, it'll be the same thing. It'll be the same thing. Like, I'm still happy and, you know.
Wait. What was the inspiration the first time?
It was you, the inspiration.
So what's the difference now, then and now?
Well, what I mean is not another inspiration. What I mean is I cannot write music during this pandemic. It's giving me panic attack left to right. So I need to get inspired. I mean, my husband is next to me all the time, but I just, maybe we'll write something about the pandemic. I'm just kidding. No. I need ideas.
No, we'll figure it out. Don't worry. No, we'll figure it out. Right?
Yeah.
We'll figure it out together, right?
Mm-hmm.
Together.
Mm-hmm.
Together.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the way. That's it. Together.
That should be the song. But yeah, if you have any idea, guys, please comment down below. Let me know. Let me know. Also, I also want to make a shout out to... our brothers and sisters, in the States,
out
you know,
there,
guys,
abroad,
be careful.
There,
no, because remember the, you know, what's been happening in the States, you know, be safe, and we'll keep you guys in our prayers, and
hopefully
we'll see each other very soon. Hopefully. Guys, the ribs is so good. It's better than Jamaican grill. Good job. Okay. Why are you stopping at the oyster? What's wrong? What's wrong?
I need to slow down because this thing is like...
Woo, kicking his butt.
If you're not used to this now.
Right.
If you're not used to this. I mean, I get the oyster, to get me wrong, man. But the smaller ones, fine. I can
big, right?
But this one here,
yeah.
Woo! I mean, it's a mouthful. You know what I mean? So I mean, I know you're not into the oyster thing, but if there was somebody, probably if there was somebody else with me that likes oysters, I would probably. You know,
I can, guys. You know, I used to love clams before, but now I don't know.
Mm.
I'm not really into like clams, oyster, or mussel. I will eat it. Like again, I will eat it, but it has to be cooked local way, like grilling it with mayo and kimchi base. That hits the spot.
Yeah.
Only because there's a flavor to the oyster and mussel.
Yeah.
That I kind of like, don't like.
Mm.
I mean, other people, they love this. Like my husband, he likes sea oyster.
Yeah.
Not me.
So, hey, so wait, for our...
another
for
prom.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know the ingredients, I guess, for the ribs, right? You know,
just remove the and give me. Sorry, guys. I can't remove the stick for some reason. Oh, that's how you remove it. Give me the eggs. I'm protecting the eggs.
I wonder why.
Because that's the most important part. Talking about.
So, anyways, for the ingredients for the ribs, right? you know, I just marinated the marination was soy sauce, vinegar, black pepper, excuse me, black pepper, onions, garlic, right? So that's the, it's a
simple marination.
Simple or basic marination, yeah. So after that, you know, I put on the grill, you know, wait it, set it down there, I set it on the grill for, you know, a couple of minutes, and then after that, you know, after I know it, if I know it's already, you know, it's already cooked, whatever, right? I'll take it off from the grill, and then that's when I apply the sauce.
Mm.
Apply the sauce, right? And then after the sauce, which I'm not going to review yet, maybe next time, I don't know when, right?
Mm.
And then I'll, you know,
a
sprinkle.
Secret.
Yeah, is the secret sauce, right? So I'll sprinkle green onions and sprinkle dried sesame seed. So that's what you see right there.
It's yummy, guys. Again, it's good with rice. Hot rice. And you go night-night for sure. I think, well, some of the family knows how it tastes. I mean, the ribs, they tried it before.
Yeah.
But I want to show this to you again.
That's shrimp.
No, it's the prawn. I got it right, guys. Prawn. Not lobster. Not lobster. It's prawn.
Just for jokes.
You know, that's what we do, guys. Oh, and if you guys are there are some people that also ask me, like, don't you get bored with my life? No, I don't. You know, every now and then you need to spice up things. Like, me and my husband, we do things together. I don't know, do we argue?
Is that part of the relationship, part of the marriage?
There's
arguments.
There's always an argument.
There's ups and downs. There's
But guys,
you know, in Tamil we call half a minute go move.
Oh yeah, I just said that to you the other day. Oh no, today I said that. Today wasn't today.
Yeah.
Well, guys, I'm learning the language too.
Yeah.
It's hard, but I'm trying. My professor, I don't know, soon he's gonna ditch me because. I don't know. It's so hard to pronounce the words.
You know why I was gonna ditch her? You know, I was giving her some, you know, Chamorro. She would ask me, "Hey, how do you pronounce this in Chamorro?" Right. So I'll tell her, "This is how you pronounce it, Chamorro." And you know, I guess after she got, I'm gonna say proficient in the Chamorro word, I would say, you know. And then she turns around and starts singing Latino. I said, huh?
It's almost the same, you know, Chamorro words. Like,
I mean,
corazón is heart, and it's the same. Same with Spanish, so. But guys, I've learned that song way before. I mean, not
here, I mean, so why I'm not gonna waste my time, you know, like teaching you how to say things in Chamorro, and
no,
then you're gonna turn around and they're gonna. And then you're going to turn around and say, sing something in Latino? Really? What was that all about?
It's for fun, you know? I mean, I'm not a good singer. I sing in my bathroom. I sing better in, I mean, at home. But out there, I'm not ready for that. But again, when it comes to the Chamorro songs, I'm still learning. You know, it's hard. I'm pretty sure it's hard for you to learn. I mean, to learn the Palawan lyrics, right?
Well, because for one, I'm not a singer, of course.
No, but even you're just reading it. Oh God! Look, another one. Oyster, not mussel.
Ooh.
It's good. Pizza. Watch out for the pizza.
EQ.
It will kick your butt. Woo, the lemon. And dip it in the sauce with pizza EQ.
Maybe we get the guac.
It's so good. You want me to fish sauce? It's his day too. I'll do it for him. You know, when I was growing up, is it fine? You can just go out down to the, you've seen the dock, right?
Yeah.
And then just go around the...
Yeah, go around the mangrove area. Yeah.
There's a lot. But I'm telling you guys, no offense to other states in Palau, but if you want the best and the best mangrove crab, you can find that in my hometown, Mukbang. That's honest truth. I'm not being money dosed. I'm telling the truth.
I was about to say that. Yeah, I wasn't.
No, but honey,
stop being money dosed about it, but you said it.
Right? No, but in fact, you know, the state, I mean the Mukbang state, they're actually growing mangrove crabs. So there are seasons where you can get mangrove crab or snap. So I'm so happy. You know, those are the kind of projects. I mean, my father is involved in that, and those are the kind of projects that I support the government. I mean, the Mukbang state government. And you can just pull it. Just pull from there. Yeah. So hopefully, the next couple of years, when you go, if you have a chance to visit Palau.
Go to where?
Mukbang. That's where my heart is at. Oh, I'm just kidding. My heart is with him, but...
Wait, what did you say?
My heart is with you.
Oh.
You have my heart. And Mukbang.
Oh, what's up?
These are good mangrove crab, actually. Mm. I've tried other mangrove crab from the other islands. It's not really, to me, it smells different. Like ocean-y smell.
But where are you going, for here in Guam, where mangrove, right?
No, there is. I went to school in Yeoju, so we had a trip there. It's in Agat, but it's not big enough for...
The village of Agat.
The village of Agat.
Okay, what about it?
It's there's probably mangrove crab, but not...
Just mangrove crab?
But it's all muddy rocks. Like...
Yeah.
Yeah, but here in Guam, they have land crabs, so...
What kind of land crab is that? What is it called?
Land crabs is the small one.
Yeah.
The small one that, on the side of the road. Like this. Oh, God.
Hey, hi, everyone out there. Hey, in closing, I want to spend time with my wife, of course, because this is our second year anniversary. So, in closing, I will say this, be safe, wash your hands, peace out.
Sitsu was ma'asi, guys. Thank you so long.
She's in the background.